the package is what I want to share with you in the name of Yeshua Mashiach. Amen. Now, in every valley of your life shall be exalted after this message. Every hill and every mountain and hill in your life shall be brought low. And every crooked path in your life shall be made straight. And all rough places in your life can be made smooth. Instead of shame, you shall shine. Instead of poverty, you shall have prosperity. Instead of depression, you shall have positions. Instead of disposition, you have been positioned. Many things will happen today. Hallelujah. Instead of you having a bronze, God will give you gold. Instead of you having bronze and wood and iron, God will turn things around and give you silver. Instead of your poverty, God will give you prosperity. Instead of your sickness, God will heal you. Because when you are about the kingdom of God, there are incentives that come to the kingdom of God business. And this one I want to share with you, as a church, we are going to focus more in the kingdom business. The kingdom business is called kingdomnomics. God trying to manage his kingdom, and when God is managing it, it's called kingdomnomics. When the world is managing people, they call it economics. When men manage things, they mismanage. But when God manages, he does not mismanage. And therefore, every country talks about economics, economics, economics. Men and women of God, this morning, God is telling us that we are not under economics. We are under kingdomnomics. And the kingdomnomics is what I am talking about. God is willing to manage your problem and your affairs. And if you let God manage you, he will manage you very well. Shout hallelujah. And there's a package for those who want to be managed by God. If you are here, you want to be managed by God, then you need the kingdom keys. The Bible says, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. So everybody that is here, God, if you are saved, you have a kingdom that has come to you. So you all have the kingdom in you. By having a kingdom without a key, you cannot function. Shout hallelujah. The Bible said in Matthew chapter 6, verse 3, and God said, pray like this, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy kingdom come, and the kingdom came. Matthew chapter 10, 6, verse 13, the Bible said, the kingdom of God is powerful of glory. Amen. And Matthew 6, 33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and all things shall be added unto you. The message of Yeshua HaMashiach is not about buildings. The message about Jesus is not about you. The message about Jesus is about God and his kingdom. And those who will do this great commandment, they have a question they ask God. What are we going to get if we get involved in doing what we want to do? What is the benefit? Hallelujah. And the benefit is the key. Amen. Because without the key, you cannot even tap into the benefit. There are seven keys of the kingdom of God. And these keys, I'm going to focus on three. The seven keys, the first key, what is more important for God on this planet is salvation. Kingdom wants is salvation. Nothing more is important. The most prominent thing is keys of the kingdom, saving souls. Key number two is deliverance. God want to deliver us from trouble and sickness and shame. Amen. Key number two, deliverance. Key number three is what we call healing. Say healing. Everybody here, we all have some ailments. Amen. And we need some healing. We are still in the kingdom. But the healing is not taking place. Before I leave, by the grace of God, some of you who believe can be healed. Shout hallelujah. The fourth key is the kingdom, what we call of blessings. The blessings of the Lord makes one rich. He has no sorrow to eat. If God bless you, no one can curse you. Shout hallelujah. And we are believing that by the grace of God, you are blessed. But you are going to be blessed even more because of what you do for the Lord. The fifth key is a kingdom called riches. The blessing of the Lord makes one rich. And God can make you rich. Shout hallelujah. Amen. And sixth key is the kingdom of prosperity. God can make you prosperous. Today the world is run by people who are prosperous, and most of them are not Christians and believers. And therefore, we are not able to push the kingdom far away. But God, in this dispensation, is going to give us a key of prosperity. And many of us shall be prosperous, and we shall be able to do more for the kingdom of God. The last key, seven, is the key of wealth. And all these keys, I've been teaching about it. But because of you this morning, I want to talk about one of the most important key for healing. Say healing. And I want to subtitle my message, 15 years policy, divine extension. Say 15 more years policy. When you have the key of the kingdom, first of all, you have to get saved. I'm sure you are all saved. Then you have to be delivered. Not all of us have been delivered. Some of us have not been delivered in so many areas of our lives. I pray this morning, wherever you are lacking, may God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob deliver you. Deliver you from sickness, deliver you from whatever. But this morning, I want to focus on healing. Because when you turn to a certain age, you begin to look for ways and means to live longer. When you get to a certain age, you are looking for ways and means to live longer. I am talking to myself. You may do everything, but you know that you are getting closer to somewhere. And therefore, my subtitle is 15 more years divine extension for your lifespan. Say 15 more years divine extension for my lifespan. Now, to get that divine extension in the policy of God, in the kingdom of God, there are some things you do to tap into blessings. There are some things if you don't do, you don't get. But as we all are into missions, we are also are aging. And therefore, we want to look at what can we get. So my point number two is that what can we get in serving God? What can we get in supporting mission work? What can we get in singing like the choir song? What can we get? What you can get is a lot. But I want to give you the most important of all. Say healing. Look at your Bible quickly to the book of 2 Kings. Hallelujah. Say kingdom healing. Kingdom keys. Kingdom healing. Kingdom keys. Kingdom healing. God is going to manage you. Whoever is sick here, God is going to deliver you. 2 Kings chapter 20. Quickly. 2 Kings chapter 20. Amen. 2 Kings chapter 20. 2 Kings. Oh, I'm talking too fast. 2 Kings chapter 20, verse 1. You've been here too long. That's the problem. You've been here too long. Come and visit and pick up some accent. Too long. 2 Kings chapter 20, verse 1. Ask man, what are you going to get if you are going to support Mission Africa? If you are going to support the community, the Bible says we should do the kingdom business. Verse 1. In those days, Hezekiah was sick and near death. Are you there with me? Let's all read together. In those days, Hezekiah was sick and near death. And Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, went to him and said to him, thus says the Lord, set your house in order, for you shall die and not live. Then he turned his face toward the wall and prayed to the Lord, saying, remember now, O Lord, I pray, how I have walked before you in truth and with a loyal heart, and have done what was good in your sight. And Ezekiel wept bitterly. And it happened before Isaiah had gone out into the middle court, that the word of the Lord came to him, saying, return and tell Hezekiah, the leader of my people, thus says the Lord, the God of David, your father, I have what? Heard your prayer. Again, I have heard your prayer. I have seen your tears. Surely I will heal you. On the third day, you shall go up to the house of the Lord. I will add to your days 50 years. I will deliver you and this city from the hand of the king of Assyria, and I will defend this city for my own sake, for the sake of my servant David. Last one. Then Isaiah said, take a lump of fix. So they took and laid it on the boil, and he recovered. Say 50 more years. Divine extension of your life. What am I going to get if I am committed to mission work? What am I going to get if I'm committed to supporting my church? What am I going to get? The first, the great commandment. If you do the great commandment, you have to ask God, what am I going to get? Let me tell you something. There will come a time in your life when you need to live longer. And when you want to live longer in the policies of the kingdom, you must know what is in for you. There was a man called Hezekiah. Hezekiah means God is my strength. And when God is your strength, that means there will come a time when your strength will be weak. And the Bible said Hezekiah was asked that get your act together, set your house in order, because you are going to die. Man of God, woman of God, if the Bible says you are going to die, you are going to die. If God says you are going to die, you are going to die. But if the doctor says you are going to die, you can change it. I said to you, if God says you are going to die, you will die. If the doctor says you are going to die, you can reverse it. And this morning, I am here to tell you that you are not going to die. You are not going to die. Because there's a key in the kingdom that whatever we lose on earth shall be lost in heaven. And whatever we bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. So if I have the keys of the kingdom, and I say to you, by the grace of God, no matter what they have said about your health, no matter what I have said about your sickness, no matter what I have said about your hypertension, your diabetic, your fibro, your cancer, your prostate, your age, no matter what they have said and they have prescribed you to be and they have given you medication, I'm saying to you, we can reverse that by the Holy Ghost power. It can be reversed. Say it can be reversed. Because some of us, we depend on doctors so much that we don't depend on the word of God. Some of us, we depend so much on our pills and our tablet that becomes your God. And therefore, it nullifies the power and the unction and the determination and the grace in the kingdom. Hallelujah. A key, the kingdom key simply means God is merciful. God is gracious. God is kind. The kingdom key is, oh, listen to me, the kingdom key one is grace. Say grace. The kingdom key is love. Say love. The kingdom key is power. Say power. The kingdom key is healing. Say healing. The kingdom key is favor. Say favor. The kingdom key is forgiving. The kingdom key comprises all that you need to be healed. It comprises all. So when God gives the key and you take the key, you can reverse your sickness. You can reverse. Say you can shut it or close it. And this morning, I am focusing on a man called Hezekiah. Hezekiah had a key. And the key he had was that he was doing good. If you are doing good and you are supporting the work of God and you are faithful and kind and loyal in ministry and loyal in the church and loyal in paying your tithes and loyal in paying your offering and loyal with a loyal heart and loyal in supporting the work of God, when you see you are near death, you can take your 15 years policy in your hand and begin to refer to God. You see, when they told Hezekiah he was going to die, he knew the heartbeat of God. He knew that he has been loyal to God. He said, God, at this point, I have nobody. You say I'm going to die, but I know your policy that you have 50 more years in your heart, that if someone is loyal, someone is faithful, someone is supportive, someone is able to do what you want the person to do, you can be merciful, you can be kind, you can be gracious, and you can reverse it. And in fact, you can even be a blessing for me to live longer. I know that. You hear what I'm saying? Let me repeat that. I'm saying this clearly. When you know the will of God, Hezekiah the king was about restoration of the kingdom. They have misplaced. They have done so much bad things in Israel. And he came in power. And he was concerned about making sure people are saved. Making sure the poor has come to the place where he or she knows God. And he made everything possible to bring the people back to God. In the midst of his goodness, in the midst of his kindness, in the midst of his service, a message came that he must get ready. He's about to die. In the midst of you serving God right now, and then you hear a message, you go to a doctor and say, oh, no. The way it's going, I think you are not going to make it. No. Take this medicine. Take that. And the medicine and the doctor put fears in you. And the fear becomes so strong that sometimes you don't know what to do. You are not happy. But I come back this morning to tell you that in the kingdom keys, in the kingdom policy, you can refer to God based on what you do for God. Based on what you do for God, when they say there's no hope and you're about to die, you can now pull your kingdom policy. Lord, I was faithful. Lord, I supported the church. Lord, I gave offering. Lord, I support the mission work. Lord, I was loyal. Lord, when the church needed money, I was there. I supported Loveland. I gave money to the church. I gave money to support the mission work. I gave money for the salary. I gave money for the building. I gave money. When you give things to God's work, when you are faithful in giving to God's kingdom work, you have already bought what you call divine policy. When you give to the work of God and you serve God faithfully in the spiritual realm, you have bought a divine policy. And when you buy that policy, when they say there's no hope and you want to live longer for your children, you want to see your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren, you want to see your business, you want to see things, everybody's going to die, but nobody want to die. Everybody want to go to heaven, but nobody want to die. So that means we all want to live longer. Can I hear some amen? When it gets that time, you have power in your hands to take your divine policy and recall. And the Bible said, Ezekiel said, Lord, remember my goodness and my loyalty. Lord, remember my tithe. Lord, remember my offering. Lord, remember my giving. Lord, remember what I have done for you. Lord, remember how I stood for you. Lord, remember. What do you have to refer to God is the key. What do you have to refer to God? I am not talking about $2 here, but be involved in the kingdom work to the point where it costs you something to say, yes, I am involved. I am doing this. Then God will say, no, sister, you are not going to die. I come by today to tell everybody here, this is your time. Arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is upon you. Your labor shall not be in vain. Your labor shall not be in vain. Your labor shall not be in vain. But what are you investing in the kingdom of God? What are you investing in the world outreach? Go ye therefore and make disciples of all nations. Preach the gospel to the whole world. Baptize them in the name of the Father. Reaching them in the street and across the street. What are you involved? If you are involved, then I am here to tell you, get involved more. Give more. Give more to the kingdom of God, for souls to be won for God, for souls to be saved, for souls to be delivered, so that God will bless you and activate your kingdom policy. Say, Lord, my sickness, my disease, I pray, remember what I have done for you and I am doing, and rescue me in the name of Jesus. My father was at the point when they told him he was going to die. So he called me to his house. I went there and said, Kodjoe, they said, I'm not going to make it. But they lie. Then he quoted Psalm 118 verse 17. Said Psalm 118 verse 17. 118 verse 7 said, I shall not die, but live and declare the work of the Lord. Everybody say this, I shall not die. I shall not die. Believe and declare the work of God. When your time is up, and you know your time is up, by the grace of God and by the keys of the kingdom and by what you do, you can say, God, I will not die. Believe, because I remember I was faithful. I remember I was this. I remember I was this. And God would say, son, I'll add 50 more years. Give you good health. Give you good health. I will add. Are you hearing me? You can say to God, Father, you are not partial. You did it for Hezekiah. You do it for me too. I am loyal. I am faithful. And so, Lord, give me more 50 more years. 50 more years. 50 more years. 15 more years is your right based on what you do for God. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. 50 more years I have come to declare and to decree and to pray for everyone here. A time will come when you need your 15 years policy. A time will come when you need it and you say, where is this preacher? I came from Africa, 22 hours and a half in the sky, to come and remind you that a time will come when you sit down and you face the wall. The doctor will be gone, the nurses will be gone, and everyone will be gone. You will be left with what you did for God. You will be left with what you did for mission work. A time will come, your son will come and visit you and will be gone. Your daughter will come and visit you and will be gone. Everybody will come and they will draw your curtains. And you'll be left alone. But that day, I'll be like Hezekiah. I'll turn my face on the wall, on my sick bed, and I'll cry. Say, Father, listen, remember me. Father, remember me for what I've done for you. And God will remember you. And God will remember you. Your 50 years policy, your 50 years policy is the kingdom of God work, which I came to tell you. You will need it. 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 You will need that 15 years policy. You will need it. My father called me and said, son, they say I'm going to die. But they lie. I'm tapping from Hezekiah. I'm not going to die, but live. Take the Bible. I opened the Bible. My father said, read. And I read all that. He said, watch. I reverse what the doctors have said. I reverse even what I say. But I believe in the word of God. And I believe in the word of God. I shall not die live. And he keep on saying, I will not die live. And keep on supporting, giving us money to do the mission work. And money. My father lived 15 more years. Exact. Shout hallelujah. You will need your 50 more years. Don't sit down and say, I don't care. When a missionary comes to you and say, let's do more for the poor. Let's do more for the needy. Let's help people get saved. Let's help people get saved. And don't see the unconcern. You will need your 50 more years policy. You will need it one day. One day. So I come back to encourage you. Don't give up in what you are doing. Don't give up doing good. Don't give up. The keys have been given to you. You can reverse every sickness in your life. Say, I reverse it. Say, I reverse it. Every pain, every pain, every shame, every struggle, I'm saying to you, my brother, there come a time when they say, your heart is not good. Say, I reverse it. By my kingdom will, I reverse it. They can say, oh, your stomach, say, I reverse it. They can say, you're not going to make it. Say, I reverse it. I have the keys to lose and to close and to open. Say, I said to you, this morning, everybody here, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, support the kingdom work here. Support the work here. Support the church. Support the church. Give and give. Support the work of God. Take it seriously. Because one day, one day, one day, you will need your 50 years policy. One day, you will need. Say, Lord, I gave. Say, one day, your wife will not be there. One day, your son will not be there. One day, your doctor will not be there. One day, your friends will not be there. One day, nobody will be there. But Hezekiah said, Lord, remember me. Lord, remember me. Lord, remember me. My grace, my favor, my kindness, my goodness towards your work. Lord, and God will give you 50 more years. I say 50 more years. I say 50 more years. Good health, good health, good health, good health. Say good health. Say good health. good health, long life, long life, good health, long life. It's in your policy. It's in your policy. Don't take it for granted. I came to tell you, there's hope for you. There's hope for you. There's hope for you. Whose report will you believe? Whose report will you believe? Whose report will you believe? Whose report will you be 50 more years? Whose report? 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 Will you believe the report of the Lord? The report of the Lord. The report of the Lord. The report of the Lord. 50 more years. I pray. Receive it. Receive it. Receive long life. Receive favor. Receive grace. Receive mercy. Long life for your sons and daughters. Long life. 50 more years. The keys. In your hands, the keys. In your hands, the keys. Your keys. Your keys is your labor. Your labor will not be in vain. Your labor will not be in vain. Your labor will not be in vain. Your giving will not be in vain. Don't be cold. You will leave your house. You will leave your house. You will leave your car. You will leave your children. You will leave everything. You will leave your bank account. You will leave your bank account. You leave your car. You leave your children. You leave everything. And then, what have you gained? What shall it profit a man if he gets the whole world and lose his soul? What shall it profit for a man if he gets the whole world and lose his soul? Remember, this world is passing away. Let's do self-save. Save souls. Save souls. Support the kingdom. For one day, the bell will ring and say, son, it's your time. Put your house in order. Put your house in order. Put your house in order. Stop being selfish. Stop being greedy. Stop being difficult. Stop being so hard. Stop being so hard. Stop being so hard. What is money? Money is an instrument in your hands. Do good. Do good. Do good. Do good. Do good. Help people. For one day, your 50 more years shall be given to you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You came with nothing. 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 Naked I came. Naked I came. And naked I shall go. Naked you came. Naked I shall go. I say, my sister, remember, one day, you will need your divine policy. God bless you. God bless you. Let's save souls. Let's save souls. Let's save souls. Let's save souls for the kingdom of God. God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you can think or imagine. Put your hands in order. Give, it shall be given to you. Good measure, press down, shake it together, run it over. Shall men put into your bosom, for with the same measure that you use for the mission work, the same measure shall be used unto you. Thank you and God bless you. I got kingdom books, kingdom keys, kingdom keys, kingdom keys. 50 more years, say 50 more years. My divine policy, I'll claim it when I need it. Thank you. Shalom.
Oh, come on. There ought to be some hallelujahs in the house. Glory to God. My God. Wow. What a word. Let's stand to our feet. Come on. Let's stand up. Amen. Wow. Would you just go before the Lord with us? And if you can, just say this. Lord, I receive this word. Come on, say it again. Lord, I receive this word. Wow. Keys of the kingdom. And this key of healing. This key of healing. Lord, I receive that word. And so as the preacher told us this morning, I want to give it all. I want to do all I can for the kingdom so that when that time comes, I can turn my face to the wall and say, Lord, here's what I did. Here's what I did. I need you to touch me. I need you to heal me now. I need you to